And maybe finally we can listen to Ian. He's going to talk about, or to tell us something as we go through the investment governance process at Washington State and how that aligns with the global regulatory best practices and the way he approaches the current African investment strategy.
Thank you. So I'm going to take us through this question. I think some of my colleagues on the panel here have touched a lot on how the board governance works at one level. I'm going to take it down to a slightly more tactical level and talk about it, how we handle it at the Washington State Investment Board. And really for us, governance really begins and ends with our mission statement, and that's to generate returns for the needs of our beneficiaries at a prudent level of risk. And that's the guiding force that takes us through our governance model. So with that, it starts with our investment team, that we set strategic plans each year. There's a lot of research being done, discovery of opportunities. It's a very rigorous process that we go through there, which is then brought to an internal investment committee. And so despite the ultimate goal is to get it through our board's approval, there's an internal committee headed by our CIO and each investment class where our teams can challenge each other, bring their opportunities there, talk, share information, and really vet the opportunity. After that set is done and an investment proceeds through that screening process, it's brought to some of our external consultants with different expertise in the particular areas. They help us dig a little deeper, provide a little broader knowledge. We're a very lean team, and so we need this extra expertise in order to continue to vet that process. Once it's through that, both the investment team and these consultants come before our board and present the opportunity there for final approval. And so this is the structure and the discipline that we go through on each and every transaction that we go through. I would also just, despite the structure that's there, I would also add to that that our investment officers have a tremendous latitude for autonomy and freedom to make decisions within the framework that I just described, so as their strategy unfolds. After that, my colleague Teresa this morning talked about our long-term focus, and that's an important part of this, and I think she touched on two issues which I'll just quickly remind you of here, which is one, that the WSIB removed country biases about 15 years ago, and that allowed us to look at opportunities like Africa and other emerging market countries. Since then, we've also, you know, my fellow panel members have also talked about educating the board, so that's a process that goes on too. Once those doors are open, it's an education and continuing education process through that. Also, I would say our long-standing commitment to private markets has also been a key part of our long-term focus. These are all strategies that bring us into the long-term. So with that, I mean, I just basically, in conclusion with that, I would say, you know, this is really the fabric of what we do in our investment process, is really the combination of this mission statement, our discipline, and the long-term and the long-term approach. So those are the three combinations. So with that, maybe before I close, I want to talk about this in the context. So what does that mean and how does that translate into what we look at right now when we think about Africa investments? And so when it comes to our opportunities in Africa, the investment officer's core outlook is really based right now on the fundamentals of an emerging middle class. And so with that, we approach this in three ways, three key ways, and these are patience. I would describe the overriding focus is patience, pace, and people. And with patience, really the long-term strategy I just described is really synonymous with patience. It's no different in Africa. For example, our real estate team is focused on really on basic housing and services around housing. And you know, risk can be higher in some of these younger economic systems. And so it's going to take us time to look at that, to educate ourselves, to learn, and be patient and make sure that we get the right fit. So with these young markets, I think I've also heard on the panel here, we've talked about transparency and stability. This doesn't happen overnight. I think it evolves in pockets, and that's what we're here to try to look at and take advantage of and make sure it matches with our own goals and objectives. Second, we have pace. I think Teresa mentioned that our investment team, Reggie Ross, who's here with us today, he talked about humility. I think that's really about acknowledging we know little, you know, and we're here to educate ourselves and learn incrementally about the marketplace, and that's going to mean that we're going to move at a slower pace. We want to match the tempo of these formative markets that we're investigating, but it's going to take time. And the third and probably most important is the people. Yesterday we had an opportunity to spend the day with one of our real estate local investors, took us on a tour around Durban. And what I walked away from that experience, aside from the education element and looking at some of the opportunities that we've closed on, as well as some future that are coming before us, it was really about how sitting with those people, I could envision them actually sitting in their office back in Washington with us. The personalities are the same, the values are the same, the way they speak about and approach the investing is very consistent with ours, and that's very important to us, that framework, that fundamental value system exists with the people that we're partnering with in the different jurisdictions that we look at. So with that, I would say, you know, as with everybody here, we look at Africa as being a really compelling opportunity, and we'll be here in the long run. I think that our long-term view we're here to learn, we're here to be prudent about risk management and evaluate opportunities that are really ultimately guided by the mission that I described earlier. Ultimately, you know, Africa is complex, it's changing, but I think our success will come from, you know, continuing to gain understanding, taking calculated risks, and really building a long-term portfolio that fits within our mission.
Thank you.
Doing business in Africa. You can't afford to be without Africa Investor.